Welcome back to Chapter 7, Conservation of Plants and Animals. This is Part 2 and we are going to discuss about species, red data book and reforestation in this video. First, let us talk about rock shelter. Rock shelter, also known as rock house, is a shallow cave-like opening at the base of a cliff. Rock shelters are often important archaeologically because rock shelters form natural shelters from the weather. Prehistoric humans often used them as living places and left behind debris, tools, and other artifacts. A total of 55 rock shelters have been identified in Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. Rock paintings are found in these shelters. Here you can see the image of a rock shelter. Now moving on to flora and fauna. Plants of a particular region or habitat is called flora. Animals of a particular region or habitat is called fauna. Next is species. A group of living organisms consisting of similar individuals capable of interbreeding is called species. They can produce fertile offsprings. So, all the wolf come under one species, tiger is another species, lion is another species. Next is endemic species. Endemic species are those species of plants and animals which are found exclusively in a particular area. Examples are Asiatic lion, lion-tailed macaque, Nilgai, this is the image of Nilgai, Nilgiri blue robin, Nilgiri tar and Malabar civet. These are all examples for endemic species. Now moving on to endangered species. A species that is very likely to become extinct in the near future. Example, one-horned rhinoceros, black buck, this is the image of black buck, Nilgiri tar, Bengal tigers, Asiatic lion, lion-tailed macaque and snow leopard. They are all endangered species. Now moving on to threatened species. Any species which are vulnerable to endangerment in the near future. Example, common leopard, great Indian bustard, house sparrow, gharial, Asiatic lion, Ganges river dolphin. So this is the common leopard, this is the bird great Indian bustard, this is house sparrow, gharial, and this is river dolphin. Next is extinct species. Extinction of a particular animal or plant species occurs when there are no more individual of that species alive anywhere in the world. Example, Sundarban dwarf rhinoceros, pink-headed duck, Asiatic cheetah. This is the image of dwarf rhinoceros, pink-headed duck and Asiatic cheetah. Rare species. Rare species is a group of organisms that are very uncommon, scarce or infrequently encountered. Example, red panda, Kashmir stag. These are the images of these two. Next, moving on to red data book. Red data book is a public document which is created for recording endangered and rare species of plant, animal, fungi, etc. It is maintained by International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. It provides complete information for research and analysis. It helps in monitoring programs on rare and endangered species. It helps to protect the species that are on the verge of extinction. These are some images of the Red Data book released. reasons for extinction of species, loss of habitat, introduction of a new species, human predation, lack of food, pollution, and increasing human population. Conservational projects in India. Example, Project Tiger. A tiger conservation program launched in April 1973. Main aim of Project Tiger was to increase the population of tiger in their natural habitat and prevent their extinction. Other examples are Project Snow Leopard and Project Elephant. Migratory birds. Our protected areas are visited by different types of migratory birds. Birds that cover long distances to reach another land are known as migratory birds. They fly to faraway areas every year during a particular time because of climate change. They fly for laying eggs as the weather in their natural habitat becomes very cold and inhospitable. These are some images of migratory birds. Moving on to recycling paper. It takes 17 full-grown trees to make 1 ton of paper. We should save paper, reuse used paper and recycle it. Through this, we can save trees and save energy and water needed for manufacturing paper. It also reduces pollution as paper industry release large amounts of harmful chemicals into the environment. This image shows paper recycling. Now moving on to reforestation. Answer to deforestation is reforestation. Reforestation is restocking of the destroyed forest by planting new trees. It can be natural reforestation or reforestation done by humans. If the deforested area is left undisturbed, it re-establishes itself. We should plant at least as many trees as we cut. So these are images showing an area in 2001 and how reforestation has changed the picture of the image in 2019. In India, we have Forest Conservation Act. This act is aimed at preservation and conservation of natural forest and meeting the basic needs of the people living in or near the forest. Now we came to the end of this video. The next video is about Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. Thank you for watching.